Good morning. It is good to be here to give thanks and praise to God for all the gifts that God has given us. Welcome to all who are joining us this day. If it's your first time, please check out our website, www.stmatthews-elca.org, to find more information about God's church in this place. This Sunday, we celebrate as a Christian church Pentecost. We hear in our reading in Acts about how the Spirit sent out the first disciples and still sends us out to be God's church, to show God's love and mercy and grace. I pray that this worship service feeds your soul and that the Holy Spirit might fill you to go out to share God's love with others. Bless you. And now, let us worship together. Good morning. Let's go see what Roxy has to tell us today. Uh-oh. She's not in her chair and her blanket is missing. Oh, no. Oh! She left me a note. Wow. And she wrote it in her own paw writing. It says, you can read it with me. It says, Mom, I have gone to look for church. Love, Roxy. She's gone to look for church. I wonder what that could mean. I mean, I know today we talk about the birth of the church in Pentecost and the church going out and telling everybody about Jesus, but I can't imagine where she would have gone to look for church because there's nobody in the sanctuary. Come on with me and let's see if we can find her and see what she's talking about when she says go, she's gone to find church. Well, she's not in the fellowship hall. Oh my gosh, I wonder where she is. Is she in the library, I wonder? Nope. Now, I would expect her to be in the kitchen because she loves to eat. But she's not there. So there's only one other room that she might be. Let's go check that room. See if she's there. I sure hope she is. Here she is. She's in the choir room. Roxy, it's good to see you. I know you've gone to look for church.
Yeah.
Why did you come in this room? And what do you mean by saying that you've gone to look for church? Yeah, I know. I talked a lot again this week about church, about all the people that make up God's church. But why did you come to the choir room? Can you show me? Can you tell me? Oh, I get it. Here's some of God's church. All the choir members, they're all part of God's church. Do you know that you're part of God's church and that you're a part of a family that is so big throughout the world? All God's children, and you are one of them. And God, this day as we celebrate church, you and me, God's kids, doing God's work, we're going to show you a video of some other people sharing the message of God. Roxy and I hope you have a wonderful day and go be the church. Show people God's love. Bye. See you later. We begin our worship in the name of God, the Creator, God, the Redeemer, and God, the Advocate and Paraclete. Amen. Merciful God, the gift of Jesus' life in us is visible in the way we witness to the fruitfulness of that gift.
deny their presence.
Thank you. your Holy Spirit. Direct us by the light of that Spirit, that we may have a right judgment in all things, and rejoice at all times in your peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is from Acts 2:1-21. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly, when from heaven there came a sound like a rush of violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as a fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages, as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews in every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native tongue of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all of these who are speaking Galileans? And how is that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya among belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs in their own language, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with a new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I pour out my spirit among all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show the portents in the heaven above, and the signs in the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Word of God, word of life.
Psalm 104 is read responsibly. How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Yonder is the sea, great and wide, with its swarms too many to number, living things both small and great.
There go the ships to and fro, and Leviathan, which he made for the sport of it.
All of them look to you to give them their food in due season.
You give it to them, they gather it, you open your hand, and they are filled with good things.
When you hide your face, they are terrified. When you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust.
You send forth your spirit, and they are created. And so you renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. O Lord, rejoice in all your works.
You look at the earth and it trembles. You touch the mountains and they smoke. rejoice in the Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah.
Send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
The second reading is from 1 Corinthians 12, 3b through 13. No one can say, Jesus is Lord, except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To the other faith by the same Spirit. To the other gifts of healing by one Spirit. To the other, another working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the discernment of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All of these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body through many are one body, so it is with Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body. Jews are Greeks, slaves are free. And we were all made to drink one Spirit. Word of God, word of life.
Thank you.
forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. The gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace, peace, and mercy to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior. Please join me in prayer. O good and gracious God, we come this day being reminded of the power of the Holy Spirit to transform, to make us new, so that we might be your light in this dark world. Come, Holy Spirit, come and fill us anew with your power, that we might be God's church. We ask all of this in your risen Son's name. Amen. Today we celebrate Pentecost, and that word has its origin from Greek, meaning the 50th, and it refers to a festival that the Jewish people had in the first century. A festival that celebrated spring and the harvest and also the revelation of the law from Mount Sinai. As Christians, we are reminded this day as we read the scripture in Acts of the birth of God's church here on earth. And we hear of the presence of the Holy Spirit in a powerful way, just like Jesus had promised before he departed this earth. In Acts, we hear the Spirit described as tongues of fire and a rushing wind. And in John, we hear a little bit different description of the Spirit. We hear the Spirit described as the Paraclete, the one who walks with us, our companion, who is always present to give us the strength to live as God has called us to live. There are so many different images of the Holy Spirit. Maybe like me, at times you wonder which one is right, which one would connect me the best way as I wrestle with understanding the Holy Spirit. Is there a right image? A friend of mine always talks about the Holy Spirit as his bird, as she calls him, sits on her shoulder each and every day of her life and helps her figure out how to live into God's preferred and promised future for her. The Holy Spirit has been described as a dove, a comforter, and an encourager. We certainly need that Spirit, that comforter and encourager, as we remember today all those that have lost their life because of the COVID-19 virus. We have lost over 102,000 people in the United States and approximately 360,000 in the world. We need peace. We need the Holy Spirit. But there are other images of the Holy Spirit beyond dove and comforter and encourager. In the Celtic tradition, the Holy Spirit is a wild goose that is loud and noisy and persistent. We need that image of the Holy Spirit as well. One that calls us to attention and calls us to action for the injustices that happen in this world. Because siblings in Christ, We are not only fighting the pandemic of the virus, but we are fighting the pandemic of so many isms and injustice for all people. Come, Holy Spirit, grab our attention and send us out to work for justice for all. And this day we remember families and friends that have lost loved ones to acts of violence. Especially we lift up the family of Mr. Floyd, who lost his life this week. While all of these images are helpful as we try to understand the Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit's presence in our life and its power to be transformative, there is one image that I like the best. And it's talked about by Martin Luther King in this quote. When our days become dreary, with low-hanging clouds of despair, and when our nights become darker than a thousand midnights, let us remember there is a creative force in this universe working to pull down the gigantic mountains of evil, a power that is able to make a way out of no way, and a power that can transform dark yesterdays to bright tomorrows. Creative force and power that can change the world from hate to love, from fear to faith and courage, from inequality to enough for all, from misunderstanding to understanding, from not being heard to being heard. That creative force and power lives in us all. In the waters of baptism, we received the power of the Holy Spirit. And that power is for all this world. A power to live in God's love and mercy and grace, not only for ourselves, but for all the world. Think about that creative force and power as we remember the description of the coming of the Holy Spirit in Acts. The disciples were locked down in a room, so afraid, so uncertain. And a rushing wind and tongues of fire came upon them and pushed them out to speak so that all might hear, to speak in the languages of all gathered. A power so great that allows us to show our love for God as we show our love for others and for this creation. The Pentecost story helps us understand what we need for this creative force and power. It reminds us that we must surrender and be humble, and that it's for both the giver and the receiver. Think about it. The disciples had to risk vulnerability in the face of difference. They weren't certain that their message or they would be welcomed into this celebration. They had to trust that no matter how awkward, how inadequate or silly they felt, the words that were bubbling up inside them, new words, strange words, scary words, were were essential words to be spoken in that place and time. And it also takes surrendering and humility on behalf of the receiver. Think about the risks the crowds had to take as they hear this message of God's love. They had to suspend disbelief. Many of them tried to just write it off as the disciples being drunk. They had to drop their cherished defenses and opt for wonder instead of contempt. They had to widen their circles and welcome strangers with accents in their midst. On that first Pentecost day, and still today, some people spoke and some people speak. And some people listened and some people listened. And those astounding exchanges God breathed in the first century and breathes in the 21st century, fresh life. And so, as Dr. King says, that can make a way out of no way. I believe, siblings in Christ, at this moment and time, we so desperately need that creative force and power of God's love for this world. We need to allow the Holy Spirit to transform our lives so that we might be the hands and of God to work for that brighter tomorrow. However, I think that call, that acceptance of the Holy Spirit, needs to come with a disclaimer. Be careful what you say yes to. When we boldly proclaim, "Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me," be ready. We need to be ready for what the Holy Spirit, the dove, the wild goose, the gentle breeze, the rushing wind, the fire that warms, and the fire that burns, how it might transform our life. We will never be the same. Who knows what might happen when you say, "Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me." You might be called to places you can't even imagine, to do things that you have never even thought about yourself, to be a voice for the voiceless, to speak on behalf of issues that no one wants to think about, let alone hear about. And yes, and that transformation, we will be able, through the power of the Holy Spirit, to make a new way, to make a brighter tomorrow. If you dare, I invite you to say with me right now, "Spirit of the living God, fall
maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and for all in need. We call on your spirit of unity, giving thanks for our different vocations. Activate and utilize the diverse gifts present in your church, that they reveal your love for all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of life, present in air, wind, humidity, storms, and oxygen in our atmosphere, breathing energy into all things. Heal your whole creation with your breath, especially those who struggle to breathe. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of healing. Bless nurses, doctors, midwives, chaplains, counselors, and hospice workers, and all who care for those in need. We pray for all who long for comfort this day. Pray for our homebound, Craig Bridges, Dorothy and TJ Bridges, Eva Clifton, Anna Sophia Reese, Barbara Reed. We pray for those who are ill or have needs this day. Tom Blunts, Jane O'Clott, Andy Bell, Debbie Packard. We pray for those who mourn that you sustain them with your peace and fill them with hope. We pray for Phyllis and John Wolfe and the death of Phyllis's mother. We pray for Janice Cameron and the family of her neighbor, Stacy Crawford, as they grieve the death of Stacy's husband. And, O Lord, we bring to you all our needs, and we especially give you thanks for milestones in our lives, especially in this season of graduation. Bless the graduates of this congregation, especially Andrew Beckman, Nicholas Mansky, and those that we name before you now. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of friendship. As Elizabeth welcomed Mary to her home, give us a spirit of welcome to those whom we meet in this congregation and outside these doors. Surprise us daily with unexpected grace, that we rejoice in every blessing you send. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And now, O God, hear these intercessions that are offered aloud or silently in our hearts.
God, give us your power and your courage to say yes to your creative force and power. May we be your hands and your feet, that we might work so that others might know how much you love them and this world. forgive us when we forget that we have been called and equipped with the power of the Holy Spirit. Come in a mighty way and send us out to proclaim your grace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Gracious God, we pray for our nation. These last few days have sparked again unrest and anxiety in people. Lord, bring peace. Bring to us greater understanding of one another. Help us to live in community that seeks the greater good of all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of these prayers that we bring before you, Lord, in your mercy, we call on your spirit of hope. As you have led your saints in all times and places, stir in us the desire to follow their example, leading us from death to new life in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. On this Pentecost, this day where we celebrate the Holy Spirit giving us the power to be the body of our Lord, the Church, we give thanks for all of the gifts we have been given from God. And we offer now a portion of them so that God's work might be done in this community, in this nation, and in the world. Please join me in prayer. Merciful God, our ordinary gifts seem small, but you make of them an abundance, just as you do with our lives. Feed us with your word for service in your name, in the strength of the risen Christ. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. At this time, I invite you to share God's peace one with another.
Peace.
Please join me in the prayer our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Share this peace with others.
We will. Thanks be.